Sleep has taken a backseat when discussing health habits for far too long. It has somehow become a mark of valor to work late into the night and cut corners on sleep. In fact, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention reports that about 35% of adults get less than 7 hours of sleep per night. Lack of sleep and poor quality sleep are bad for your health, and that's a big deal. A good night's sleep allows your body to experience several important cycles, including REM sleep and deep sleep. Both enable your body to restore and repair itself, regulate hormones, and consolidate memories. Specifically, our bodies are busy healing and repairing cells, tissue, and blood vessels, and strengthening the immune system. All combined, this improves your mood and energy level, but it also improves your brain function, including alertness, decision-making, focus, learning, memory, reasoning, and problem-solving, all things that we could use help with every single day. This is important work, and your body needs significant time to do it. Over the long term, sleep deprivation may put you at higher risk for obesity, high blood pressure, high cholesterol, high blood glucose, diabetes, cardiovascular disease, cognitive decline, which means not thinking as well as in the past and having dementia in the future, and depression. So, how much sleep do you really need? Adults should aim for an average of 7 to 9 hours per night, and that's not an arbitrary range. The body's circadian rhythm seems to require that amount. Think of the circadian rhythm as your own personal body clock that runs on a 24-hour cycle. It's directly influenced by environmental cues, especially light, which is why circadian rhythms are tied to the cycle of day and night. Babies and young children under 5 need 10 to 16 hours of sleep every day. Kids between the ages of 6 to 12 should get between 9 and 12 hours every day. And teens require 8 to 10 hours of sleep. Napping can be helpful, but naps cannot fully replace a good night's sleep. A short nap of 20 to 30 minutes can provide a quick boost of energy and alertness. Naps can also improve your mood and your ability to think, but they don't provide the same benefits as a full night's sleep. In fact, relying on naps to compensate for poor sleep can lead to a cycle of sleep deprivation and daytime sleepiness. Basically, naps are a supplement, not a replacement for good sleep habits. So, is there such a thing as too much sleep? This is emerging science. But what we suspect is that needing more than 9 hours of sleep per night might be an indicator of other health issues for adults. It may depend on your own personal clock. Again, that circadian rhythm. Any disruption to it seems to throw sleep out of whack. Here at the American Heart Association, we have a handy tool to remind people of the key measures for improving and maintaining cardiovascular health. We call it Life's Essential 8, and it includes sleep. I encourage you to make getting good quality sleep on a consistent basis a top priority. The result is better health, less stress, and less risk, that is, a lower chance of chronic disease like cardiovascular disease. If you have questions about health conditions, I would love to hear from you. Comment below, hit subscribe, and join me here next time for Answers You Can Trust.